Dan Mahinty set to jump it up. Steve Olson, Don Daly, Kelly Self are our officials. We're underway here from Birmingham, and the Blazers get the opening tip. Watts inside, looking for the first points from Mahinty. Dirk Williams. A lot of passing here to open on that first possession here, Jordan. A three-pointer on the way from Watts is no good. And it's Justin Johnson who rips down his first rebound of the night off the miss. Entry pass knocked away. Good denial defense there by Mahinty on Lawson.
Mahinty with that length. A good post defender. Some good high-low basketball to start. Solid defense from Johnson fronting the post on William Lee.
Johnson, the defensive board, and then a great job in the interior, turning that away to Pancake Thomas.
It's going to be a fight all game long with Johnson defending down low against Ha Ha Lee.
Johnson off the rim and in. Count it, and he'll go to the line for one more.
Johnson, incredibly compact guy, low to the ground, undersized at that big spot, but a knack for scoring the ball. And this is just your old-fashioned pass, give and go, cut in front of the defense. Too many guys watching. Not enough guys protecting the goal, and that's just savvy basketball from the junior.
Dirk Williams whistled for his first personal. Johnson attempting a completion of the three-point play, a 61% free throw shooter, unable to convert, so it's 2-0 Hilltoppers in the early going.
The Hilltoppers will go to him early and often. Most experienced returning scorer for the Hilltoppers.
And another and-one opportunity, this time at the other end for the home team. Tosin Mahinty converts inside. He'll go to the line.
Coach Eason looking like the basketball Buddha. Inserts Mahinty into the starting lineup, trying to get him some confidence. He wastes no time notching a few points under his belt to get going here. That could be some momentum and a confidence builder for the big fella.
Mahinty, an 85% free throw shooter, and converts. They give UAB the early one-point advantage. Just over a minute gone here in the opening half. A little bit of a pressure ply to Western Kentucky, bringing the ball across midcourt.
UAB, such a deep team, throw a lot of bodies at you, enables them to apply full court pressure, get up in you and guard relentlessly for 40 minutes.
This is Thomas, another one of those grad transfers for Rick Stansberry's team. And the shot from Q Johnson falls.
That's where Q's at his best, with momentum coming off a screen, utilizing his teammates to create an advantage and create some space, a catch and shoot guy.
Johnson, one of those all-important keys added during the offseason. Coming in averaging just over 15 points per game to lead the way for the Hilltoppers. Hakeem Baxter leaves it in the corner. Mahinty back now to Baxter. Nice move with the left hand. Oh, and the follow finish from Mahinty. And they wanted some more aggressive action on the floor from Mahinty, and they've got it early.
Yeah, that's just frustrating if you're Western Kentucky. You're digging a guard for 30 seconds. You do the job, you defend the layup, and you don't get the rebound because there's no help sign.
And he has all five of the Blazers' points in the early going.
You can tell Mahinty excited to be in the starting lineup.
Johnson eyes flies and fills a three.
Such a dynamic matchup, and most times a matchup nightmare. A guy who could go inside and outside. He makes the big guys dance on the perimeter and run through screens. And if he gets a smaller guy on him, he takes the mouse of the house.
Western has yet to miss Western Kentucky on their first three field goal opportunities. Johnson, a 48% shooter from distance. Mahinty again.
Man, no answer for Mahinty. Looking Olajuwon-esque with the footwork down low.
Interesting that Mahinty is in there, and they expected Chris Coakley to go in the game.
Well, you would think, one of the top players on this team, trying to give him a different look. Coakley, a selfless player, okay with coming off the bench, and right now paying dividends with a performance early on for Mahinty.
Mamba to Johnson, a little bit of a fadeaway on the baseline. That's no good. And the rebound comes down to Ha Ha Lee. Ahead to Baxter.
Well, I'd go down low to Mahinty once again.
Mahinty. It's been Mahinty versus Western Kentucky so far in these first few minutes. He's got it again. And this time, they said he took an extra step. The home crowd in disagreement with the official on that call. Boy, what does it do for the confidence, Jordan, of a player like Mahinty, who's kind of stepping in to fill a role? Really, he's there so Coakley doesn't have to worry about picking up early fouls, yet he's the guy scoring all the points.
It does a lot because your coach is the one inserting you in the starting lineup, which gives you that confidence. Says, hey, coach believes in me to be one of the first guys on the floor to contribute. So I'm going to go out there and play fearlessly and not worry about anything else as a foul's called off the ball. But it's been Mahinty early on for the Blazers. Mahinty all night long likes the porch lights to start this game. He's creating some energy. He's active. The interior scoring with phenomenal footwork. We got a tie ball game here in Birmingham, Alabama.
Tie ball game here in Birmingham early on, 7-7, but really the story for UAB has been Tosin Mahinty, a young player averaging 5.9 points a game, and Jordan's already got seven, all seven for UAB in this game. If you're wondering, a season-high 13 points for him earlier this year. He also one of those key in the defensive end as well, 147 block shots, third all-time at UAB. This is Pancake Thomas who turns loose the three. That one off the front of the rim, no good. The Blazers come away with it, Dirk Williams. Lee can't get position, the switch on the defensive assignment, and the entry pass to Mahinty knocked out of bounds. As we see for the first time, Anton Waters into the game for Western Kentucky.
And you can see Western Kentucky looking for the antidote to the interior scoring, both the both physical Waters and also the double down from Q Johnson.
Inbounds comes to Williams. And looking to get it inside to Mahinty again, draws the double team. Ha-Ha Lee puts it to the floor and off the glass for his first two.
And what I like in that sequence, Mahinty catching. He's been hot scoring it as you have a turnover from Western Kentucky. The Mamba frustrated by the pressure early on, but Mahinty, who's been scoring and having success early, still not forcing the shot. Good rhythm, good feel, feels double team coming, plays off his other big man and distributes to Lee for the easy lay-in.
Coming off his first start of the season is Mahinty. He started the last game, as we talked about, kind of a strategic move. And we still have yet to see a substitution. And why not? What does that say about Coach Ihsahn keeping this five intact, not disrupting this chemistry and rhythm they have going right
now? Well, it says if I'm a Hilltoppers fan, I'm a little bit worried because Coakley still hasn't stepped into the lineup.
Yeah.
He's one of the best players in this conference. So speaks to the depth of this UAB team, but also speaks to the promise and potential of Mahinty this season.
And Mahinty and Waters jousting for position. And they're going to go ahead and get Waters with the personal foul. That's his first. I wonder if, from a defensive standpoint, they're probably having to make adjustments here on the fly with Mahinty. They probably weren't expecting this kind of offensive.
Well, they were expecting an interior score in Coakley. They just weren't expecting it to be Mahinty. So different personnel creates a different look, but he's giving you the same lift that Coakley will give. As Coakley now sets to check into this game.
Turnover for UAB. their third. And a couple of substitutions now for both teams. Damari Paris checking into the game for Western Kentucky. And also Deion Lavender and Chris Coakley coming in. A couple more players coming to the scorers table to get in the game as well, including Tyler Miller, number 15, into the game for Western Kentucky, as well as Jabari McGee. McGee, a transfer from Tennessee, and just recently becoming eligible. This is just his 10th appearance of the season. Transfer from Tennessee. Literally, Jordan set out the calendar year. Left Tennessee last December and couldn't play for literally 10 months almost to the day. And a turnover as Waters call for the trap.
And this is where you start to see the struggle with the Hilltoppers, a team that has pieces, especially these grad transfers who provide that experience and productivity, but they're without a point guard. And you're seeing that with the press it's put on. There's been some early unforced errors, some forced, but also no rhythm offensively in terms of a point man getting pieces into place in sweet spots to score the basketball.
It's interesting to talk about both teams really having to find point guards. Nick Norton, the outstanding point guard for UAB, lost in the 11th minute of the first game of the season. And Mahinty with a big rim rocker inside, and his night just continues to evolve.
And once more, the Blazers putting on that pressure. A travel, you can tell the Hilltoppers uncomfortable with this pressure because there's no primary handler. Conversely, Mahinty down low. Just flashes, shows two hands like you're supposed to. Tough on the catch, wins the 50-50 ball, and then it's daylight in the hoof.
Mahinty is putting together quite a night already with 9 points.
Here's the zone look from the Hilltoppers trying to confuse a rhythm. Works to their advantage here. Can they translate defense and offense?
Lavender tried to force in a pass. It's stolen, and Pancake Thomas brings it back the other way for two.
Talking with Coach Stansberry earlier today, he said, defensively, we're not where we need to be. I can do a better job. I can't be on the floor to play defense, but I can implement a couple different looks to disrupt the offense from the Blazers. You're seeing that early on. They started man dominant where the Blazers offensively. Now you see a little 2-3 zone look to try and mix it up a little bit.
And Coakley tries to force it inside, knocked out of bounds, will stay at this end.
And here's what I'm talking about defensively. That 2-3 zone, active hand starts with Waters. Pancake Thomas corrals it, and he finishes at the rim with some nice touch. Body control to avoid the charge.
Western Kentucky, 4-6 from the floor. UAB, 5-7. And it's UAB with 5 turnovers, with the Hilltoppers giving it away 4 times. Lavender with a nice move as he goes around Paris.
I just think as inept defensively as Western Kentucky is, they may be best served playing that 2-3 zone and force UAB to shoot it to win this game. They just cannot contain them to a man with the personnel on the floor.
Thomas gives it up for McGee, and he has it blocked. It looks like Coakley might have got a piece of it on the way up. No, it was Mahinty with the block, and another block for the big fella. 6'9 senior.
Mahinty, just great timing right here, and he says, this meat is undercooked. Send it back.
148 block shots now in his career, and a much deserved breather as he goes to take a seat on the bench.
Absolutely, there's no more active a player in this contest to start. He's been the difference, the reason why UAB leads by 4.
Nate Darling now into the game for UAB. Blazers protecting a 4-point lead as we approach 12 minutes to go here in the first half. A little floater on the way off the front of the rim, and it's Haha Lee who comes away with it. Here's Lavender, pushes it for Darling. Lee for 3.
Lee's got that ability. He's not just a shot blocking big man who scores down low and tip dunks it. He's got that side to his game, like all these young big men these days can step out to 3 and are a threat with the long ball.
Shot at 34% from 3-point range this season. Hugh Johnson with it, leaves it for Paris on the far side, right in front of Robert Eason, coaching his crew on the defensive end.
Waters working for that ball down low. They simply won't give it to him. Had to settle for a deep Hugh Johnson 3. Like to see some isolation on one side of the floor, play some two-man basketball. Coach Stansberry likes to work it inside to go outside. haven't been able to get the low post touches as of yet.
Oh, McGee almost got away with the travel. That's what the crowd wanted.
Oof, wide
Johnson
open.
Picks up his dribble, finds McGee wide open. Shot is no good as Waters trying to tip it around. Oh, and down hard to the floor. Is Tyler Miller, he gets up.
Oh, what a tough kid.
Wow, I mean, certainly the back of his head hit the floor. And he seems to be okay as he comes to the sideline. A back and forth game in this one. UAB hanging on by four. UAB on top by four over Western Kentucky. Back and forth affair in this one so far, and a clash of titans in Conference USA. Best plays for the best players after our game. Keep it on Campus Insiders to instantly watch all the top hoops highlights from around the college basketball nation. That's on campusinsiders.com. And we've had a couple of good ones here in this one, especially from number 21 in gold tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. You almost think if you're Mahinty, you pull the Costanza and you walk off. It's been such a good start for the young man. Perfect from the field. 4-4, 9 points, an assist. Yes, there's been three turnovers. You can shore it up there, but a highlight film block. Keyword, buzzword, active. And that's what you wanted to see from Mahinty. A very nice young man, well-mannered, but sometimes you want him to have that edge to him. Well, it's provided by Coach Isan putting him in the starting lineup, and it's paid dividends for the Blazers.
It does that to a mentality of a player, doesn't it? Even both ways, whether you go from the bench to a starter or from starter to the bench.
Yeah, I think it gave him that necessary lift to show the coach has the confidence in him to be one of the first five on the floor to contribute and set the tone and playing ahead of one of your stars in Coker.
Johnson gets it in the low post. His jump hook over the left shoulder bounces off the back of the iron. Blazers come away with it. Deion Lavender crosses midcourt. Aha Lee, these are for Javian Williams. This is Darling now. Coakley, cut to the basket. Darling turned away and went back to Lavender. Coakley from 16, yes.
Not the best looking stroke, but it counts for two. Coakley more of a back to the basket guy, but if you give him the open 12 footer, he has the capability of knocking it down no matter how it looks.
Western Kentucky just one of their last six from the floor. Thomas. They get it down to Justin Johnson. The turnaround is no good, but fouled on the way up. It looks like they might hit Coakley.
Yeah, late whistle too. I don't know if that call is the right one, but either way, it was the right decision for the Hilltoppers. Going down low to Justin Johnson. Let's take another look. Johnson gets that low center of gravity, but Coakley as a defender the same. I thought that looked all ball to me. He did cave the arms, but he only got ball. So let's see here, like Rasheed Wallace said, ball don't lie. He knocks down the free throw, so maybe it was a foul. I really like Justin Johnson, what he brings to this team. The most experienced, most productive guy coming back to a team with so much chaos on the roster. and a new coach, he provides stability for this team and a scoring interior option, which can hopefully open up this offense if you can establish him down low.
Had a double-double in that tournament game last year against UAB and a heartbreaking loss. A huge performance from Johnson, looking to have another one here tonight.
Yeah, where the Hilltoppers were dominant in that contest on a backboard, create second chance opportunities. UAB's done the job there thus far, but maybe this Hilltoppers team can start to compete in the interior and match the effort from the Blazers to start.
The ball kicked out of bounds, and you get a look, another look at Eason over there in the sideline on the bench for UAB. And Robert Eason was an assistant coach elevated to head coach. And Ha-Ha Lee with a nice move and a good look inside, too.
Yeah, you can tell Coakley and Lee play a lot of ball together on the same page immediately on the catch. A cut in front of the face of the defense to the rim. Ha-Ha Lee gets the last lap.
They can go nine deep, can UAB, and they've got three at the scores table ready to come in at the next dead ball. Johnson's jump hook again off the mark, guarded by Coakley. And Blazers looking to get out. Coach Eason said he liked to run a little bit more, turn these guys loose. Has to trust him. Coakley off the back of the rim. The tip was no good. The Hilltoppers come away with it now. They want to push the pace. Thomas thought about the three. Crowd on that end wanted another travel. No whistle. Q Johnson. Triple try is good.
Pancake Thomas does a good job with just a couple probing dribbles. Has the defense commit to him. Kicks back out to Q Johnson. Wide open, high percentage three-point look.
UAB, seven of their last nine from the floors that they're at this end, and a rare make for Western Kentucky.
And I'll tell you what, Ray,
their last eight.
You look at the score, and this Western Kentucky team hasn't played their best ball, simply trailing by four. Any man's game right now.
Right. Lee, that's good for three.
Justin Johnson late to get out defensively. Lee has that to his game. Crowd comes alive.
That's 7 points for Ha-Ha Lee. And a whistle. I believe they're going to get Lavender, I believe, with his first personal foul. Lavender, the sophomore from Alton, Illinois, a guard. And he once was in the starting lineup, was Deion Lavender. And just until recently, they've gone with Denzel Watts because Watts, number one in gold for UAB on the floor now, as a matter of fact, a better three-point threat.
And also a more steady handler as well. Both those things, the combination of the two, have put Watts in the lineup. And you've seen this UAB team playing some of their better basketball. So Lavender immensely talented, but right now Watts provides that stability.
Thomas a little off balance. It's no good. Mahinty comes down with it. And it's three rebounds now for Mahinty to go along with his 9 points. Approach 7.5 minutes. Oh, nice little nifty move by Hakeem Baxter. Can he hang on? Oh, just lost control just by that much of the nifty move out top. But this has been Ha-Ha Lee and UAB who have started to build a 7-point lead here with 7:31 to go in Birmingham. Lee with another triple. UAB looking to stretch it. Back here with you, fans, young and old, excited by what they see right now. At least the home team fans are, as UAB with a 20-13 lead here in the first half.
Yeah, William Lee, is a phenomenal athlete and a versatile one who can do so much for this team. How about the catch from Coakley? High IQ cut from Lee. High percentage layup, two guys that play well together. And then Lee, when you're a big man defending, you're so used to Lee, just you assume he's gonna come into the paint. But this guy, the modern day forward, is a stretch one and can step out and knock down that 3-point shot. On pace to hit his average here in the first half. Lee getting it done. It's been the interior play of this Blazers team that has been the difference early on, and that's why you see Western Kentucky a 7-point deficit. These bigs, impressive athletes, lengthy ones who do a lot on the floor.
Aha Lee, the Conference USA Defensive Player of the Year from last season. 192 career blocks. They call it Blockingham here in Birmingham, affectionately known, the hashtag.
Felt really embarrassed when I had to ask why I was blocking him.
Oh, and it's RQ turned away by Haha Lee. And the tip in is no good. Second, third effort. Unable to convert to the Hilltoppers. Here comes Watts. His pass almost taken by Thomas. And this one knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Western Kentucky.
Ray, it's like he was listening to you here. Check out the timing and just the impact. Tell your friends it was nice to meet him, but I hope I never see him again. The shot block, the timing, and Bill Russell-esque keeping it in play. His teammates couldn't get it, but this is a guy who has just the blocking in his DNA. I mean, the team 5.4 on the season, but this guy's good for three in a game. And like I said in the pregame, when it's all said and done, he'll go down as the all-time leading shot blocker in Blazers history.
Watts for three with the shot clock down to three. It's no good, but how about this? The long rebound comes out. Oh, and he's drilled hard and hits the floor. And Watts is rolling in pain. And it looked like Pancake Thomas. This is going to be...
I don't know if it looked like it might have been McGee.
Intentional.
I think it was McGee. Clearly it's intentional. I think they're going to look at this. And if it was McGee like I think it was... And maybe it was Thomas, we'll get another look.
Yeah, there are a couple of UAB players talking to Thomas.
I think someone's gonna be sent packing here, Ray. Well, I think it was McGee. Let's take a look here.
So the long rebound comes out.
Oh no, it was Pancake Thomas. And it didn't look like he was making any sort of play. Yeah, he wasn't making a play at the ball. Yeah, that's malicious intent. You're not going for the basketball. You're out to hurt somebody in their most vulnerable state when they leave the air. I think the official can take a look at this, and Pancake Thomas may be done for the night.
And that would be a tough loss for Western Kentucky, to be sure, down seven. And you lose a player that averages 12.5 points a game.
Oh, they're just going to go.
Are they just going to get him? Yeah, we still await to see. One thing is for sure, that'll be the third team foul for Western Kentucky. As we mentioned, Watts in the starting lineup in the last couple of games. The fans here in the arena getting a look at that for the first time.
It's just the impact a foul like that could have, the negative impact. A powerful, explosive athlete leaves the floor and is incredibly vulnerable. And you go for a clothesline of sorts.
Let's see if they're just going to call this a two-shot foul. Let's see now. We're going to see Thomas is going to come over to Watts. Those guys are going to embrace. The crowd obviously unhappy. And he wasn't tossed from the game. Another look.
Good sportsmanship from Thomas to go over and apologize amidst the boos, but sportsmanship better late than never from Pancake Thomas. And that clearly coming from above, the classy coach and Coach Rick Stansberry.
Yeah. Watts, an 80% free throw shooter, able to convert, and they will maintain possession. We get a look at Stansberry.
And knowing and talking with him and what he stands for, I know he's unhappy with the foul, and Pancake Thomas is going to talk him to in the post game. But he stays on the floor.
whistle away from the ball, and I believe they got Denzel Watts with his first personal foul. And some pressure applied, taking advantage of the fact that, Jordan, what you pointed out, Western Kentucky with no real true point guard, LaMamba is running the point. He's never played point in his career up until this season.
LaMamba played 3 years of basketball at Providence as a small forward, not even an off guard. Illegal screen there on Jabari McGee, but going back to LaMamba, LaMamba's a guy who's not only not played point guard, he wasn't even really utilized as a shooting guard. So that's how far in between this guy was and what kind of jump he had to make at the point guard spot. And Coach Stansbury, you talk about coming into a tough spot. It's not like he had a non-talented guard on the roster, a walk-on guard. He had no guards, Ray, when he came into this program. So he literally had to go out there and grab guys. Junior LaMamba was a guy from Providence who wanted to play the point guard spot. So professionally, when he went overseas, he had that on his resume. But Coach Stansbury couldn't go see the guy. He had to go off the faith of film, and that's the kind of position he was in. And LaMamba's learning on the fly at the point guard spot with a team that has a lot of pieces learning as they go.
And UAB also with the loss of Norton to the ACL tear in game one of the season. They too in a similar spot trying to find a point guard.
I think Denzel Watts may be that guy. He brings a little bit of experience. He brings some steady play. In conference, he's knocked down the open shot, and that's what you want at the point guard position. With such a strong interior, you just want somebody to alleviate some of that pressure by knocking down open shots.
15 foul for Western Kentucky. The free throw off the mark from Williams. Unusual for him to miss, an 87% free throw shooter. In fact, UAB, one of the better free throw shooting teams in the country at 78%.
I'll tell you, you won't find many that knock him down collectively as a group, like the Blazers.
They still are as a team, though, in the game 4 for 5. So that was the first free throw miss for UAB. Johnson crosses the stripe. It's turned over. Watts, the race to the rim. And timeout.
Here's a magnification of not having a point guard. Denzel Watts picks the pocket and finishes with the offhand. And you've got your big man, your hybrid forward, Justin Johnson, bringing the ball up because you're out of options against the pressure. Junior LaMamba uncomfortable at times, so you go to your most experienced guy in a Western Kentucky uniform to bring it up. Even he's not comfortable with a point guard checking him. It's a tough task. Didn't pay dividends right there. Defense to offense, Blazers go to the huddle with some momentum here, Ray.
Justin Johnson, you talk about Mr. Everything, except, you know, you can't go to the well too many times with one of your better players. Certainly one of the most outstanding players in the league. Several double-doubles this season. But asking him to bring the ball up the floor and avoid the pressure. Tobias Howard into the game. He checked in a few moments ago. And he's checked by Dirk Williams. This is Johnson strong to the baseline in the two-hand finish.
Good action there, roaming the baseline. That short corner catch. Rising two-hand jelly from Justin Johnson. Maybe this can give his team a lift.
That's 8 points now for Justin Johnson. And the big guy logging some big minutes here for the Hilltoppers, as you would expect. Williams' three is no good, and Johnson corrals a rebound. Under 5 to go here in the first half. A 10-point lead for UAB. Western Kentucky looking to chip away at this. Tosin Mahinty back in the game for UAB. Boy, did he start hot in this game, scoring the first 7 points for UAB. Justin Johnson, he can play a little bit with his back to the rim, but give him that much room on the baseline, he takes advantage.
Yeah, he did a good job of, even before the catch, carving out that lead space. Just a savvy, wily move from the veteran to, before the catch, create a path to get to the rim.
Thompson's three is good. And Pancake Thomas with the triple. That's 5 points for him in this one. Akeem Baxter swings it back all the way around. Julian Williams. The shot is off the mark. Thomas eyes it, flies it, and that's no good off the rim. Tobias, the little man with the rebound, his turnaround's no good. Third effort and a block inside by Mahinty. Johnson nowhere to go. And a new shot clock. And somewhere in there, it touched the rim. Waters nearly lost it, guarded by Coakley. Pass out top, nearly stolen away. Q Johnson able to track it down. Six to shoot. Johnson. That one's off the mark. Williams with the rebound. Akeem Baxter drills the three.
Again, Mahinty making the winning play. Catching and playing the role of facilitator to kick out for the open look for Baxter. Mahinty doing it all for his Blazers right now.
Some of these fans rise to their feet in the play of UAB in the defensive end as a team effort and scoring the three at the other end. Timeout on the floor. The UAB on top by 10 over Western Kentucky. Well, no shortage of excitement here in the first half. 2:55 remaining. UAB with a 10-point lead over the Hilltoppers. This week on the Seth Davis Show, Seth talks to Duke's basketball coach Mike Krzyzewski about the loss of his brother, why he chose to stay at Duke, and what he plans to do once he steps down. Watch the exclusive interview only on campusinsiders.com. You know, it's interesting, Jordan. You meet a lot of coaches in your travels. We both do, and it's interesting to see a young coach like a Robert Eason at 34 years old, and you try to envision 20, 30 years from now, could this be the next budding great coach in college basketball? Yeah, you know somebody's in the pipeline. It's just a matter of who it is and when they will kind of come onto the scene.
He earned his stripes under Gary Williams at Maryland, so he's got a good mentor if there's one to learn from.
Yeah.
A legend, a heavyweight in the game, a national champion. Gary Williams had some great teams there out east in the DMV area, and it was a lot of it because of a guy like young coach Eason.
Inside the Waters turns, and well, that's brave to try to go over Mahinty.
Yeah,
he's able to do it.
Another one of those shot blockers, and Waters has struggled early on, but to his credit, has not given up. Intestinal fortitude, continuing to fight. Gets two to go.
Waters, the senior from Baltimore.
Oh, here we go.
Backdoor alley-oop lob, and a vicious throwdown from Javian Williams has this crowd on their feet.
Yeah, that was a set play drawn up. You could see creeping behind the defense was Javian Williams, the young freshman. Some bounce to the ounce.
Great execution on the backdoor lob delivery. Thomas. That's no good. The tip from Waters off the mark as well. Oh, and UAB saved it and touched. And back in the hands of Western Kentucky. Q Johnson's shot's off the mark. Mahinty hangs on to the loose ball, and UAB comes away with it. And that's four rebounds now for Mahinty. And a timeout.
How about this for a finish, Javian Williams? If you're not going to wear the seatbelt, get in the back seat. A high riser, young freshman, always in attack mode, high ceiling for him. This is one of the guys Coach Eason said he really likes, thinks he's going to be a future star. Checks a lot of the boxes as a young kid, young man, excuse me. This guy's going to be a big time player for UAB.
And at 6'4", that elevation, like you like to always say, my friend, an extra step.
That young man's ladder. That's right, brother. We've done a few games together. You know your guy's sitting next to you. I get excited when I see a guy with some bounce. And this guy's coming off a 14-point performance versus Rice. Confidence is high. He's been getting it done. I really like how he's performing and how he's coming of age as a freshman.
Likes to attack the rim, as we just saw. No better example. You mentioned Jay to 14 points against Rice, a career-high 21. And a win over Stephen F. Austin. And that game against Stephen F. Austin snapped a 31-game home win streak. So already UAB has played the spoiler. And played some big, big heavy games, even in the early goings of this year.
Yeah, Javian Williams is a real wild card for this team. He talked about that 21-point performance. But when this guy is on, he can be special. Coming off also a career-high 30 minutes in that Rice game. So he's starting to feel comfortable with the college game. Starting to slow down for him, and he's starting to find real success.
Number 22, Tyler Madison in the game, checking Waters on the pass down low. And Howard's shot is no good off the mark. Here's Lavender. Looks back for his coach for some instruction. About a 1 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Eyes fixed on that red number, counting down to 7, 6 to shoot. Spin move is Lavender with the left hand. It's off the mark. Waters the rebound. Are they going to get a shot off? Thomas at the buzzer. Off the mark.
Don't think it would have counted anyway. Not sure if the release was off in time for the red light.
An action-packed first half here in Birmingham. Bartow Arena witness to another chapter in this long-storied rivalry between Western Kentucky and UAB. Of building the Hilltoppers have not won in 22 years, and they go to the locker room trailing by 10.
Yeah, healthy dose of the toast. Tosin Mahinty was the difference to start. Active defensively, the shot blocks, UAB all first half. Let's see what we got in the next stanza.
To show off their depth, 10 players for the Blazers have minutes in this one tonight in the first half. Depth was one of their strengths, and we have seen it on the score sheet. Set to go here in the second half after UAB won the opening tip. Possession arrow starts in favor of Western Kentucky to open the second half. Glad to have you along with us in Campus Insiders. Pancake Thomas feeling it early from distance.
Pancake Thomas is one of those guys out here early during shoot-around. Even after shoot-around, really working on a three-point stroke. This is a guy that knew the shot would be available. Worked on it, paying dividends here in the second half.
Mahinty guarded by Lawson, and gets it over the seven-footer.
This guy picking up where he left off to start the game. It's like deja vu here to start the second half. High percentage shots, getting close to the goal, carving out space.
So give a couple more to Mahinty. Now 11 for the game, and just two away from his season high. Denzel Watts with it, who took a hard fall on a controversial foul committed by Pancake Thomas. Officials took a look at it, the shot off the mark. Here come the Hilltoppers, and now a carry by Lumumba. And the turnover, UAB will get it.
And those are the simple errors you don't have if you have a point guard within the program you can rely on. Lumumba, it's like watching an off guard or a guy who's played the small forward position, a talented kid, a great young man. He's just playing simply out of position, out of necessity for these Hilltoppers.
Williams, Dirk Williams hits a three. That's when you have a couple of guys going, and Ha-Ha Lee and Williams from distance, it's gonna be tough for the defense, and a nice move. Carving his way inside, La Mamba gets to the bucket and scores. That's his first two of the night. Still a 10-point game just underway here in the second half. Oh, and a block shot, and they're gonna call goaltending on Lawson on the drive by Lee.
Really fun to watch how Ha-Ha Lee moves without the basketball. A lost art, especially with the young men in this game. Leads with his hands, shows it to make himself an obvious receiver, and just cutting without the basketball. It's the toughest thing because so many guys in high school, another travel, Justin Johnson this time, but going back to Lee. So many kids come out of high school as stars who dominate the basketball. And they get to college and realize they're surrounded by stars who also dominated the basketball, and they're unfamiliar with how to score without the basketball. Lee is not one of those guys. Exemplary with scoring without having to control the ball.
Eight turnovers and another big throwdown. This one from Dirk Williams.
And guess who? Mahinty again, the distributor, making plays.
That's the largest lead of the night for UAB. Rick Stansberry decided to keep a timeout in his pocket, at least for the moment. La Mamba hits a three with the answer.
Stops the bleeding a little bit, keeps him within 11. Defense sags off La Mamba, fully capable of knocking down a three-point shot.
UAB working it outside. Mahinty trying to find position on Lawson in the low post. Lee hanging outside. Now he tries to drift down inside. Five in the shot clock. Hakeem Baxter drives, block. Mahinty there gathers a loose chain.
Mahinty seems to be in the right place, right time.
11 points, five rebounds, and another turnover. Here comes UAB. Dirk Williams will wait for his teammates. Swings it around. Watts between the circles. Mahinty gets behind the defense, blocked on the way up, and draws the foul. Ben Lawson is going to get hit with the personal.
How about right here, Mahinty, the distributor, but this time it's Lee. Kicks it over to Mahinty, and then you reach, I teach, the back cut and the finish. Dirk Williams up, up, and away.
Yeah, Mahinty at the line. Now it's matched with the 13 points, matched his season high. And now there's a new season high for him. Free throw falls for his 14th point of the night.
I'll tell you, there's not a graphics package that can contain everything that this guy has done just with that little font, because he's done it with the assists, he's done it with the blocks, he's done it, yep, with the steals. There's not enough room on a screen to show the stat sheet stuffer that is Tosin Mahinty.
Mahinty sinks them both. And the lead grows to 15. 16 and a half to go here in the ball game. UAB applying that pressure. As we again point out, La Mamba at that point guard position. Played at Providence as well as a stop at Cleveland State. So this is his third school in his collegiate career. Justin Johnson shot off the mark. Williams hauls it down. Williams. Ha-Ha Lee with a nice move. Mahinty with a two-hand flush. Tosin Mahinty, have a night, big fella. ...17 points for Mahinty. And a timeout. As this one's starting to get away from Western Kentucky, it's been all UAB here to start the second half. Dirk Williams with a fantastic finish. And Mahinty through the air with flair. And a hot start here for UAB. Six of their first eight in their field goal attempts and haven't turned the ball over, protected the ball extremely well. Western Kentucky has gone 3 for 5, Jordan, here to start the second half, but have turned the ball over three times.
Yeah, I look more at the execution of UAB, taking care of the basketball, running good offense, making the extra pass, getting the high percentage shot. And you can tell Western Kentucky may have ran out of gas in that first half because they're really struggling without a point guard to find a rhythm and find stability to stay with their head above water in this one.
All right, so just that quickly, we come back and we send it back to the break as Ha Ha Lee knocked it out of bounds. It'll be Western Kentucky's ball when we return. A 15-8 start for UAB here in the second half in downtown Birmingham on the campus of UAB. And what a great weather here to enjoy some unseasonably mild temperatures in the low 70s today. We've enjoyed it. Campus Insiders, your home for Conference USA Hoops. Our next exclusive game comes Saturday. We've got to look there at National Signing Day actually coming up. And that will be quick. It'll be a big one here. This is a whistle and a foul. A big one here at UAB, Jordan, because their football program comes back next season.
That's pretty big.
Yeah, so
you saw
be
how
something.
Many people were disappointed when it left. Super excited to have this back. This is a fan base that loves their Blazers and gets behind them, as you can tell by the lively crowd this evening.
There's Justin Johnson at the line. This is the first of two.
But I like Western Kentucky going down low to Justin Johnson. Again, oxygen. A little rattle there from Justin Johnson.
And a half minutes to go, 4.5 minutes gone here in the second half. It's really been all UAB in this one. Western Kentucky is just struggling at the line at this point. Aha Lee, another three for the 6'9 junior from Plantersville, Alabama. Johnson saves it from nearly being turned over. Mahinty right in his grill on the defensive end, and he's going to get hit with foul, maybe a little bit too handsy there defensively.
I call that the first eight foul. No hands, Ray Crawford. And how about this? Lee again. The range. The man is a unique talent. He's letting them know about it. Tickles the ear, flashes the three fingers to let the scoreboard know in case they get it wrong. It's a three-point shot. Incredibly efficient. Ha Ha Lee has been this evening.
Western Kentucky now inbound underneath their own basket. Johnson and LaMamba can't hang on to it. Denzel Watts, here it is with Thomas again defending. This time nobody hits the deck and Watts gets the bucket.
In the city of Watts.
Now the last time we saw those two go one-on-one, it was Watts who hit the deck hard. They had to review the foul against, committed against him by Thomas. A nice move back at the other end.
Hugh Johnson off the bounce, doing what he can to stop the bleeding. You look at this Western Kentucky team, and they're smallish, dominated by guards and grad transfers, but not the most explosive athletes. So in a lot of ways, they're a step behind the length of athleticism that UAB presents on the floor.
Shot clock down to six. Baseline move from Chris Coakley.
Fantastic.
And he scores.
Seal.
Comes up a little bit limping. And he has, as we were told, been still nursing a sore ankle, Jordan. Hugh Johnson's three off the back of the iron. Shot on the way, in and out, no good. Long rebound as Coakley tries to chase it down. I don't know, it's Coakley kind of goes hobbling into the crowd of photographers in the first row. You got to think that he's a tough individual, tough young man, but with so much depth on this team, you think you maybe give him a little time to get to the bench.
Yeah, and you're looking.
You need him. It's a long season, Jordan.
Absolutely. Depth on one side and a roster that was kind of molded together last minute with the situation and Coach Stansberry taking over this team. But let's also take a minute to say that the cupboard may not be full now for the Hilltoppers, but the future incredibly bright with the job Coach Stansberry's done with his top 25 signing class coming in next year. A five-star center, Mitchell Robinson, who by far is the biggest recruit this school's ever landed, alongside some other pieces. Stansberry's going to dig his feet in, leave his footprint, and Western Kentucky, Ray, going to be special.
Well, and perhaps their point guard you mentioned on the way, Lamonte Bearden, an all-MAC performer from Buffalo, sitting out due to transfer rules this season. Well, Rick Stansberry told us today he is going to be a very, very special player.
Yeah, four-star guard Josh Anderson as well. When you think top 25 classes, Western Kentucky doesn't really come to mind first, although they have tradition and they've had history of success within conference. But the job that Stansberry's done immediately, and we talked to him and he said, hey, look, I don't want to win in 3 years like some coaches that come in and say, give me a three-year window to rebuild. I want to compete for championships right now. Like, and I got the sense he wasn't doing a lip service. It wasn't a used car salesman pitch. He looked directly in my eyes, and he was serious. He said, we're going to have our opportunities. Tonight's looking like it may not be one of them, but there's going to be nights they steal wins in conference. They're going to improve throughout the season, and they're going to have that opportunity. And when they reload next year and these guys get a little bit older, watch out for the Hilltoppers.
Block shot by Coakley. Williams to Lavender. Deion Lavender finishes the transition.
That was a blur, wasn't it?
Anton Waters down low, out to Q Johnson. Howard for three, that's no good. Here comes Coakley, UAB with numbers. Nate Darling, no. Ha-Ha Lee, Coakley. Tip-in.
It has become volleyball.
Ha-Ha Lee, Johnny on the spot, on the tip. And this UAB crowd on their feet, lead out with 14 points. Thomas off the mark. Lee at the other end, the finger roll and the foul.
Between Mahenty and Lee. Lee has absolutely taken this game over, Ray. Coast to coast, all the way. He waits for nobody. UAB rolling.
Welcome to Blockingham, indeed. 90 blocks this season for UAB, and they've put four more on that board here tonight, big fella.
Just so explosive, long length athletes that are bouncy, great timing, and it comes from several different bodies. Most notably, it's been Mahinty, it's been Lee, but it's also been a little bit of Coakley, and those block shots have translated into offense quickly, like a blur on the other side.
Love to get your thoughts as the all-time leading shot blocker at Notre Dame, the anatomy of a block shot,
It's a great question, Ray. It's all about timing. And I was an anomaly. I didn't have the athleticism these guys had. I had the length, and I had the timing, and I had the IQ. But I couldn't jump out of the gym, and I couldn't have my arms touch end-to-end on the floor when I extended them. These guys are versatile athletes that are long and bouncy, which makes them exceptional shot blockers. I was just really good and good at help side. These guys can block the shot head on and can do it with flair.
But there is a knack, isn't there? Kind
it's all
of
about
a,
timing, absolutely.
A timing and anticipating the play. And coming to your side and being right there. McGee barely hangs onto it on the baseline, backs up and gets it to go and draws the foul. Tyler Madison looks like he's going to get hit with the personal. And speaking of personal fouls, as you point out, Mahinty with three fouls in the game. Might have stepped out of bounds here, Jordan. I don't know. Let's take another look. Awful close to that baseline. There's McGee with it. Just keeping it just in bounds. And converts, does McGee. 67% free throw shooter. Averages 6.7 points a game. Again, just playing in his 10th game after sitting out transfer rules from Tennessee. And they might get Mahinty here again. And if they do, that's going to be his fourth. And indeed, that's the fourth foul for Tosin Mahinty.
And an unnecessary foul for Mahinty, a guy who's been flourishing on the floor, coming of age in the 11th hour of his career as a senior. You're not going to get that basketball, so just get back, play defense. And by playing defense, I mean go ahead and block another shot.
In their game, which is an overtime victory in Houston over Rice, Mahinty did foul out in that game. So foul trouble is something that is kind of haunted him at least these last two games. He once had 10 block shots at a high school game. Hugh Johnson, the three is off the mark. Javian Williams comes down with the rebound.
Now here's the beauty of the Blazers defensively in those shot blockers. When you're blessed with a couple shot blockers on deck on the floor at all times, you're allowed to take risks as perimeter defenders. You can get up in and guard, you can cheat, try and get in passing lanes, because you have erasers on that last line of defense, which makes your defense that's that much more aggressive and disruptive.
Darling drives and gives it up for Madison. And a second effort by Tyler Madison. That's his first points of the night. Now, among the 10 players to get minutes in this game, the only one not to score, Jordan, for UAB is Nate Darling. Everybody else is in the book.
Man, Ray, how are you gonna put him on blast like that?
He's got a lot. He's got 9.5 minutes to get in the book, and he's on the floor right now.
He's got a great first name. He's also got a great stroke. This guy is lights out for this team, especially in practice. Now, can he translate it to the big stage? Remains to be seen, but they love this guy as a shooter.
Now, second, third efforts in there. Ha Ha Lee came flying in to turn away one of the shots, but they got Javian Williams, perhaps.
I'll tell you what, Ray, band of brothers, man. You gotta rent that one. Oh, Darling under the bus. He's got his homies out there listening to the game. The only guy not to score, Nick Darling. Come on, man.
I'm going to give him the reverse. It's the reverse jinx. When you mention it, that's when he opens it up and explodes. Tear it up here the rest of the way. Now Ben Lawson checking into the game. Anton Waters will go to the bench. Jabari McGee at the line for Western Kentucky. He had 5 points, a couple of rebounds, and the loss to Old Dominion last Saturday. And a career night, though, against Florida Atlantic, 13 points, 9 rebounds. And the whistle. Ha Ha Lee kind of brushing away from his eyes a little bit, making sure sees everything. Tobias Howard whistled for the personal for the Hilltoppers.
Ha Ha Lee, only a junior, so you got to think between rest of this season and how it plays out bleeding into next season, along with Coakley coming back, these two young men can really be dominant as a front line. Really impressed with his style of play and the skill set and so many things that he can do on the floor.
And now the crowd getting a little antsy in the anticipation of that young man, Thomas Smallwood, at the scorer's table. A youngster from France, 7-footer. So we're going to have between him and Ben Lawson, we're going to have two guys north of 7 feet in the ball game at the same time as Ha Ha Lee gets a well-deserved, let's listen to this ovation.
I think these fans know a little bit about basketball. They know that man deserved a big cheer as he checked out of the game. The difference tonight, Mahinty got it started. Lee carried him on through.
7 of 8 shooting for Ha Ha Lee. You talk about being deadly from the outside, including a couple of triples in this one. You see Smallwood, guards McGee. Thomas from way out as the shot clock horn sounds. He saves his own rebound. And there's Jabari McGee in a nice hustle effort. After the Thomas miss, he hustles to keep it in bounds and able to get the hands of McGee with a throwdown. And 7 for McGee, all coming here in this second half. Darling, will it get in the book? That's off the back of the iron. And it's Javian Williams who climbs up, unable to bring down the rebound.
That young man has to bounce. He really does have that extra step on his ladder as he attacks the offensive glass. A guy that coach really likes because he's in attack mode at all times. Hasn't been great from the three-point line. I believe he's something like 2 of 17. But that is not indicative of his stroke. This is a shooter. This is a guy who can put it on the deck. This is a guy that attacks the rim, knows how to get to the free throw line. A fearless offensive rebounder from the perimeter. A lot of tools for the young freshman.
And he's showing them all are on display in this game tonight. Robert Eason trying to get everyone into this one on that UAB sideline. Howard, Lawson guarded by Smallwood, turns and fouled on the way up. And that's who they're going to hit for the personal foul. Timeout on the floor. This one, all UAB at this point, up 63-39, just under 8 to go. UAB came out hot to open the game, came out hot out of the locker room after the break, lead at 63-39, and really kind of pulling away from Western Kentucky here with 7:55 remaining in the game. And it has really been a two-man show in some respects for UAB, a great team effort. A lot of guys getting into the action tonight, but you see the points that Mahinty and Lee have combined for, and then the rest of the team.
Yeah, usually you're accustomed to hearing Coakley and Lee.
Yeah.
Those guys being the productive duo, but tonight it's been Mahinty inserted in the starting lineup for Coakley and deliver with Coakley-esque numbers and a Coakley-esque performance. Productive, active, defensively getting after it, rebounding. Mahinty's one of those guys who's who's a mild-mannered young man and needs to play with that edge. And tonight, I think he may have turned that corner, being one of the tough guys and playing like it, and has been the difference alongside Ha Ha Lee.
Two have been pure joy to watch. Smallwood, add another name to the scorebook for UAB. UAB shooting 60% from the floor in the second half. They shot 57 in the first. McGee drives, that shot is off the mark. And going down, McGee, will it fall? No. Can't get that shooter's bounce, it falls off the front of the rim.
To the Hilltoppers' credit, continuing to fight.
And a look at Smallwood, the 7 foot, 240 pound sophomore from France. Left all alone. Finish with the left.
Jabari McGee, one of those guys billed as the junkyard dog, a tough guy, competes high motor, likes to do the dirty work, whatever he can to get his team in the game. And this one's just one where he hasn't been able to have that impact. The guy who missed the first half of the season due to transferring rules had to sit out. I think he's getting back into game shape and getting the feel for the college game once again, having been removed for a season.
Brings energy, some toughness, and I've been a huge contributor on the defensive end. But like you said, I mean, it's hard, isn't it, to sit out 12 months of competition. You can get up as many shots as you want, practice as much as you want, even scrimmage, pickup games. But there's nothing like putting on the uniform. And yeah, Rick Stansbury even said, I got some guys that are great at 3 o'clock, and at 7, you don't know what they're going to be.
And some of these guys are in midseason form because it's middle of the season. When you got a guy like McGee who's in the beginning of his season in a lot of ways.
Junior Johnson on the steal from Watts, the two-hand flush. That's 10 points for the 6'7 junior from Hazard, Kentucky. Smallwood gives it to Mahinty. Williams for three, that's no good. Mahinty with the rebound. And it looks like they're gonna hit Q Johnson with the foul.
There hasn't been a lot of them, Ray, but Justin Johnson getting in that passing lane and finishing with some punctuation.
And they're gonna need him once they try to recover from this outing tonight. Dirk Williams, that's no good. Smallwood almost had it for a rebound, loses it. Johnson comes away with it for the Hilltoppers. Thomas for three. Pancake Thomas, almost exclusively the man from three-point range for Western Kentucky. It's 11 for him.
A little bit of a 1-3-1 zone look. Hilltoppers working on some things. This is a team that's got to grow within games.
Now Denzel Watts, he answers. Give him 9 points. 42% shooter from three-point land drills one there to answer the shot from Pancake Thomas. Now Howard for three. Now we've got a whistle and a foul as the two big seven-footers going at it, and Lawson and Smallwood. And they hit Smallwood again with his second personal. Get a look at Lawson, start of the game. His first points, though, coming at the stripe, looking to add to it. The average is 5.5 a game, 3.5 rebounds. This is his 14th start of the season in this game tonight. Got 3 points in that loss to Old Dominion Saturday. Second one off the mark, off the front of the rim. They're coming toward us over here at the table, chasing down a loose ball. Last touch by Lawson. So it's going to be UAB basketball right in front of us at midcourt. Oh, good luck, Mahinty can't get the one hand flush to go. Comes off the back of the iron for Q Johnson, and he is gonna get called for the foul. Smallwood draws the charge.
You talk about the depth of this team, contributions from seldom used guys like Smallwood, who you never know, could play big roles for this team, a team that goes 10 deep. I do think there was a foul before the charge came that was overlooked from Denzel Watts. He's got his hands in there, but productive play off the bench late in game for Smallwood. Gotta love it.
And that's three for Johnson. UAB at five block shots in this one. They're ranked 25th in the country in that department as a team. 5.4 game. Mahinty picked up the dribble.
Back into the Blazers. Tonight, slide, slide.
And a save for Pancake Thomas. Western Kentucky has struggled from three-point range, shooting just 33%. And UAB has done a good defensive effort in trying to defend the perimeter. They only gave up one three against North Texas two games ago. Thomas's triple is no good. Thomas is 3 for 8. The most successful shooter from three-point range. Smallwood for three, the big seven-footer, as the crowd in anticipation might have blown the roof off this place. The seven-footer hit a three. 4.5 minutes to go here in Birmingham. UAB in control, up 68-47. Worth mentioning again, 1995, the last time Western Kentucky won in this building. And a three-pointer off the mark. Back comes Western Kentucky. Johnson with a nifty little behind-the-back pass. Justin couldn't handle it. Justin Johnson. And last touch by Johnson out of bounds. Get a look at Rick Stansberry, a veteran coach, spent all those years at Mississippi State. Now Mahinty will go to the bench, but you get a look at Stansberry again with what a career he had at Mississippi State. He's another guy, much like Robert Eason, started as an assistant at Mississippi State in Starkville in 1990 and eventually elevated to head coach, 14 years as a head coach, most recently at A&M, the last Texas A&M the last 2 years. Dirk Williams scores inside. That's 8 for Williams now. 6th NCAA tournament appearances as a head coach, Rick Stansberry, and they're hoping that will continue under his tutelage. And so with 9 wins in their first 17 games this year, as Lawson tries to go baseline, unable to finish inside. So UAB and Robert Eason should be all smiles in this one. His team up big with 3.5 to go. UAB dancing all over Western Kentucky here with 3.5 to go, up 70-47. Jordan, that looks like some pretty good moves there. Campus Insiders, your home for Conference USA Hoops. Our next exclusive game Saturday when Southern Miss visits Charlotte. Tip-off time, 8 o'clock Eastern, 7 Central on campusinsiders.com. A lot of young fans, the next generation of fans here at UAB. As the football season kind of comes to a close, we all know Alabama is big for college football, but now the tide's done. season's over, they can focus on basketball. And since 2012, Jordan, nobody's been better in the state than UAB.
Their state, Blazers. A lot of tradition, a lot of history. Great fan base. It's a fun arena, too.
It is.
It's got a good feel, got a good buzz about it. Make no mistake about it. UAB likes to play here in front of them. An elevated performance this evening.
UAB, 89 wins on their way to their 90th win since 2012. Again, comparing to Alabama, who has 83 in terms of basketball. So the Blazers are the team in this state, to be sure. And we talk about two first-year coaches, two different stories in Robert Eason and Rick Stansberry, but coming in under different circumstances. Three on the way, no good. Darling with the rebound. And a new shot clock here as we approach 3 minutes to go. As UAB content to just kind of wind the shot clock down and take some time off the clock, Jordan. This game, they're on their way to win 10 of the season. They'll improve to 3-1. Shot on the way with 5 on the shot clock. But Stansberry comes in, the slate was clean. Ray Harper resigned in March. They get Rick Stansberry in April, early April. He goes out and gets a whole new staff.
Charismatic guy, can recruit, knows how to win. See Mississippi State in his career there. An assistant coach at Texas A&M. Brought some big time talent in there. Teams that enjoyed at Texas A&M, some of the best in the history of the school. Guy knows how to win. It's fun to talk to today. Makes complete sense as me being a former athlete, understanding what is alluring as a coach, and that's the kind of guy you want to put on a uniform and run through a wall for, to be frank about it.
It's interesting, after the shoot around, he and Johnson just sat and before they left and just talked for a little bit. And Justin Johnson on the and one there for Western Kentucky. And if they have success this year, you know that he's going to be a big part of what they do. Here's Darling. That three-pointer is no good. LaMamba comes down with the rebound to Q Johnson. But conversely, though, on the other end for Eason, he steps in a more smooth transition as Pancake Thomas, one of the few offensive bright spots tonight for Western Kentucky. He's got 14 points now in his fourth three of the night. But Eason, a smooth transition, an assistant on campus since 2009, and just a nice, easy move in to the next head coach, has some stability. And the key pieces remain. And a nice bucket inside by Tyler Madison. He almost looked surprised when he turned around and nobody was there.
Powered up, thought he was going to see some contact. Saw no defense.
Johnson's three on the way. That's no good.
That man was home alone like Macaulay Culkin.
We touched on it briefly. We should mention it a little bit more. Nick Norton, an all-conference performer, been sitting on the bench, tore his ACL. And, boy, you think how good this team would be, UAB, a great night tonight, how good they'd be with him as a point guard.
He has a point guard who provides that stability, provides that primary handler, also provides scoring and a deep three-point threat. So this team's having to figure it out on the fly at the point guard position. Denzel Watts is going to be that guy, it looks like, but it's going to be by committee. Regardless of all that, what an impressive performance tonight from these Blazers.
No question. As the chant of UAB rings from the crowd to tick off these final 25 seconds. Three to shoot. Williams, three-pointers, no good. Justin Johnson has it with 15 to go. Five to shoot. And Deion Lavender will run the clock out. And the buzzer will sound as Robert Eason and Rick Stansberry will meet at midcourt and shake hands. As UAB improves to 10-7, 3-1 in conference, Western